Hey student, did you know that Populi gives your instructor the means to build online discussions in their courses? I hate to break it to you, but it's not likely that they're doing this for their own amusement. Chances are, your instructor would probably like for you to get in there and get involved in the discussions that they've so lovingly set up. So let's see how to navigate to a discussion and then what participating in one looks like. To get to a discussion, from the home screen, click My Courses. Then select a course title. Over on the left, click into the Discussions view. Here we can see all of this course's available, future, and closed discussions. Alongside each one is a circle with the total number of comments and replies that have been posted in that discussion. If the circle is blue, it means that there are new comments or replies that you haven't read yet. If it's white, that means there are no new posts since the last time you checked in. This paperclip over here indicates that this discussion is attached to the Ingmar Bergman lesson. So, you can access the discussion of the seventh seal here, or in line with the rest of that lesson's content if you were to hop over to the lessons view. Another thing to note is that one of these available discussions has the graded discussion tag as well as a due date, and this other discussion has neither of those. And that's up to your instructor. A quick disclaimer. Populi gives your instructor a lot of options when they're creating a discussion. In light of that, a discussion in your course might look really different from what you're seeing here, but just know that the general concepts will basically be the same. Now we'll take a look at what adding a comment in a discussion looks like, and then we'll walk through the different ways that you can interact with what others have posted. Go ahead and click the title to open the discussion. Here in the center, we can see the specifics of the topic that your instructor would like for you to write about. Over on the right, we'll find the requirements that your participation in the discussion will be graded against, and below that, some general information about the discussion. For this discussion, your instructor has decided that before you can read anyone else's comments or replies, you have to contribute your own comment. So we'll just start to add a comment, and as we're typing, you can see the word and character counts updating just under the box here. The requirements were 2 comments, 2 replies, and a total comment word count of at least 200. This comment didn't hit that number, but we'll get to 200 words with the next one or even a third comment. Click Add Comment, and now we can take a look at what everyone else has to say. Like this great comment from Bruno. We'll click Reply and interact a bit with what he wrote, and that fulfills one of the 2 replies required in this discussion. We can also drop him 5 stars since the instructor enabled peer ratings. In some cases, these ratings could be part of the discussion requirements, so make sure you're being fair. Your classmates can't see who left which rating, but your instructor can. And it looks like Tim here decided to share some of the plot synopsis ripped right from Wikipedia. We'll click these 3 stacked dots here and report this comment. Now the instructor will be notified and they can determine what should be done. You can go back through and reply or give ratings to any of these comments now, or you can check back later after more classmates chime in and continue interacting then. And that's the general idea of how discussions work in Populi. Again, the discussions in your particular course might look really different, but now you at least have an idea of what commenting and interacting with posts in discussions looks like. If you'd like to learn more, there's a link to our knowledge base article about discussions in the description of this video. Thanks for watching, and thanks for using Populi.